be disturbances in the natural state of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says, and I quote, there will be famine in the land. Jesus says, Matthew 24, verse 7, he says, there will be war. Famines. It's a plural. It's not singular. And there are famines not in one place, in many parts of the earth. Are you aware that 1/6 of our population is about to die because of food? 1/6 of our planet is about to die, or they die. Listen, 10,000 people die every day because they can't get a bath, even a bath. Pepper soup, just to get heat in the stomach, they can't get. 3.5 million people die just because they don't have food to eat. It is estimated that some even die because of malnourishment. Ladies and gentlemen, our world will experience starvation because the arable lands are being used even to build high skyrocketing homes. Arable lands, where they used to farm, they are now cities. Jesus says, when you see hunger, when you see poverty, when you see starvation, don't just look at them and groan. They are signs that Jesus is coming again. Luke 21, verse 25, he says, upon the earth will be distress of nations with perplexity. God has given the blazing sign. Ladies and gentlemen, if you watch the world, this is saying there will be pestilences, diseases here and there. My brothers and sisters, there are challenges in the world. Look, more medical research, more sickness, more nurses trained, more people die, more drugs develop, more cases, it cannot solve. Human beings. See human beings. I was in the city of Monrovia. I'm in the midst of Ebola. I was there for an evangelistic series just like this. You meet anybody in the airplane. Nobody wants to touch anybody. I forget that I'm coming from God. You want to say something? I said, that's okay. You go to church. Happy sir. That's okay. Nobody wants to church. Mothers. I was preaching in a place called Bush Island. And there, and then also at Peace Island, and one woman walked up to me. He said, Pastor, I said, what's the problem? He said, I want to see you right now. I said, Mother, what's the problem? She looked at me for 3 minutes, she could not talk. She said, Dora, she's lost fortune in Ebola. The mother died. The grandfather died. She was left alone. My classmate or schoolmate in a university returned home after graduation, went back, and she died. Ebola is deadly than HIV is. The horror is still fresh in the minds of people. Young thousands went to their grave premature. When I see these signs, it tells me Jesus is coming again. My brother, the siren is so clear. Strange diseases. The Bible says, Revelations, blazing sirens. But is it only sickness and disease? The Bible says, no, there will be earthquakes. People wept for 50 years. It takes 2 minutes. And all their investment will come to nothing. 2 minutes earthquake will bury over 500,000 people beneath the earth. What are we human beings? What are you proud? Why are you so arrogant? Why are you so self-centered? Jesus said, earthquake, Matthew 24, verse 7, there will be earthquakes in many places, various places. Be careful. It may come close to you. It may come close to me. Jesus prophesied in the book, Revelation 16, verse 18, and said, there will be noise, and there will be thunderings, and there will be lightning, and there will be a great earthquake, such as a mighty and great earthquake, as have not occurred since men were on the earth. Earthquakes happen 6,000 each year. It's a sign. Jesus is coming again. Look at people's structures. My brother, where is your hope and your boast in your buildings? Where is your pride and your whole life revolving around your cars and your properties? A day just is close by. There will be earthquake in various places. See, Japan reduced to nothing. At the time, the second most impregnable economic nation in the entire world. Poor countries like Haiti see massive destruction. Jesus says, Luke 21, verse 11, and there will be great earthquake. Look at the adjective. Not just earthquake, great earthquake in various places, famine, pestilence, and there will be signs in the heavens. And the Bible says, and there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and on the earth. Distress of nation. The stress level of people will go with perplexity. The sea will be roaring. That girl, she died. One rain came into my country. It washed away 157 people just because it rained for 3 hours. See people's cars. 4x4. People go to Malabs to kill their people, their friends, their enemies, their parents, to drive a four-wheel drive. It's like a matches box. Spilling of baptism into the ocean. That is a 16-story building. Look at where it was raised. Raise! Jesus is coming. All over the world, we have seen extreme, extraordinary weather. Typhoons, tornadoes, with waves, tsunamis, hurricanes, volcanoes, all these, they are blazing sirens that Jesus is coming again. But Jesus said the sign is in the religious world. The sign is in the political world. The sign is in the natural world. The sign is also in the social world. Ladies and gentlemen, there will be moral conditions, moral depravity, moral indiscretion all around the world.